Hello? Welcome to another grand casting presentation. Boy, I hope this is live right now. I've never run videos or ads in my life. I don't even know if my mic's on. But we're going to assume it is and hope for the best in 2 minutes. FDL versus Team Doo-Wop, and boy, is it looking like a good one, because if you don't see on that Doo-Wop side, we have Way Too Sexy, unfortunately, is unable to play tonight, so we have Juby standing in, and oh man, God bless America, do I love me some Juby. Anyone who doesn't is a liar, and we know that for a fact. First band's coming out, FDL going to take out Elder Titan, as well as the Bat Rider. Pretty standard bands, and then Oracle and Drow, so literally the most standard of bands. Shadow Demon still in the pool. We know FDL, yep, OD for 747, Susie God himself. Yep, should be, we're going to assume Doo-Wop wants to do some sort of Shadow Demon lineup here. You don't really want to give away OD and Shadow Demon, but heck, who knows? We've seen crazier things. Snake King drafting as well, I guess with Way Too being their drafter as well, we're going to have Snake King doing it. They do have a semi-experienced drafter in Jason, who used to play for Team Shazam, so should be decently okay. They should be fine with the drafting. But we are just going to wait here. They're going to use a little bit of their time, which is smart. It's, you know, picks. Nothing like picks. Picking your nose. You know, that's always good to do. Have you ever been to a berry farm? You know, picking berries off the trees? That's fun. I mean, picking's just fun all the way around. And they're using a lot of their reserve time already from Doo-Wop. We could also see a Wisp. I think that might be what they're deciding. With Juby standing in, I think when you have Jason and Way Too, well, looks like they're already going to prove me wrong. But I think it's smart. With Juby, you have a super good Wisp player. I'd say Juby's probably a top three North American Wisp player. And with Way Too and Jason really not being huge Wisp players, it gives you another add element. But the problem is he's a stand-in. You don't want to, like, Io's such a weird pick. And there it is. The Omni Knight counter, the counter pick, like, ban. If you ever go against OD Omni Knight in a public game, you'll understand why you never want to see it even in a pro game. So reasonably smart pick there. But you're already giving up something. You either have both your supports, or you're running that Omni Knight in the offlane. And we've seen Flea do it, but look at that. FDL just takes their axe straight away. Could be a 4, could be a 3. Most likely an MJW. You see MJW play a lot of heroes quite like that. So, should be good here. Kunkka getting a banned out. Looks like that might mean they want the... They might have the Omni Knight in the support role, which we've seen him do before. FDL. Stan King is quite a drafter. At the Summit 5, when I gotta go, I gotta meet them. Stan King is very smart up in the brain sector. I was pointing at my brain like my webcam was on, but it's not. Up there, he is just super smart. He finally quit Dota quit his job to go Dota full-time for this year and this year only. If it works out, obviously he can do it more, but I'm really hoping for the best here. That is our one hope, is that they do well, and they have. They already qualified for the Beat It LAN, so we're going to see FDL on first LAN. And if they win this, they're going to already be going to two NA LANs, get to show us what they're up. Now that they got rid of CC and C for 747, should be decent. As well, 04, a lot of people don't know who 04 is. He is one of the old school, I would say, Dota 2 players. He was a 2011 player, like August, one of the early beta players. He always stacked with, say, Mason and all the other... you know, the Team NP people, the Weebs. And that, I mean, that was what it was called. You had the Tyranno stacks and the Weeb stack. He was on that, so he's a very good player. You'll see him play a lot of Run at You. He's the Run at You player on their team. Ogre, Pudge, whatever supports they want to pick, he will do that. So we'll see. And wait, bans come out slowly but surely. 5 seconds remaining. Time. Now, should be good, you know, just fixing, tweaking some settings here. Juggernaut, Sand King banned out by FDL. I mean, Juggernaut, Sand King's one of the few that can kind of go toe-for-toe with Axe a little bit. Half the time, once a few levels get up, then Axe starts spinning on, and it's not pretty. Just an overall decent ban. Ricky banned out as well by Doo-Wop. A lot of people think they're Evernova S. They are not technically yet. They are just Team Doo-Wop, so who knows what fell through there. But Snake King, one of the legends of the heroes of New Earth scene and the early Dota 2 when he played on Dignitas. Always stay hydrated, friends. We wait. This third pick here for Team Doo-Wop. We sit here. We wait. We anticipate Slardar comes out. So they take both their supports, and it looks like they're offlaner already. A little bit surprising. I know when I talked with Peter, when I was casting with him, he says it's always good to pick one support, but picking two support shows way too much of your hand. And Shadow Demon Omni Knight, I mean, that's a pretty big showing. You have two very defensive supports in Shadow Demon Omni Knight, and Shadow Demon obviously can play a little more aggressive, but I mean, generally when you pick him, you want to play defensive. We'll see if that actually happens. Reserve time. FDL now going to take a little bit of time here. They have their axe, they have their OD. 747's OD literally carried Team NP, or literally carried FDL last time they played against Team NP, so we'll see if he can do it again. A nerf here or there isn't going to stop Susie. Light blue. Beeza. Always memeing, you know? My name's Bean. No, it's Beeza. I've literally told him every time I see him, can you just change your name back to Beeza? He's like, no, this is a little bit funnier. Oh. Beeza. Rest your soul, my friend. Dazzle picked up. Never mind. Axe heal bombs, always a big thing. Dazzle, just an overall good defensive support.
10 seconds remaining.
Doo-Wop looks like they're going to dip again into their reserve time. Reserve. Man, you ever gone to a restaurant and thought, like, you're going to a nice restaurant. We'll say, in Colorado, we have one called Shanahan's. Used to be owned by Mike Shanahan. It's a steakhouse. Very nice. I walked in there one day. They're like, sir, your reservation? And I'm like, excuse me? I just want a steak at this point. They're like, your reservation, sir? And I walked out. I didn't have one. I don't know what the point of the story was. Always make reservations at nice restaurants. Morphling coming out. A little bit of a deny pick again by Doo-Wop, actually. We know Beeza loves playing that Morphling, just an overall strong carry. I think one of the strongest carries in the game right now. Split pushes, team fights, and just does well in lane. Just extremely good hero right now. We're going to wait, probably see possibly Doo-Wop's mid hero. It could be a middle Snake King Morphling, but it's doubtful. Grant, is it? Yeah, OD versus Morphling is just terrible for the Morphling. FDL now waiting. See what their next pick is. Either a support or possibly their carry. Unless they run Axe carry. We saw a team earlier do that in Complexity. That didn't end well. They'll take their time. Look at Omni Knight. Purest Thunder Wrath. What a name. When my mom named me, she said, your great uncle's name, middle name was Grant, so we named you after him. Like, that's all the thought you put into it? She's like, yeah. I'm like, thanks, Mom. Terrorblade, so another Beeza classic. Stan King's way of drafting, he has... It's really hard to explain. He has almost, like, just a pool of 30 heroes, and they draft from inside that pool, but sometimes, like, we saw it. Was it the last Summit, Summit 5, when they played OG, and they picked Troll? And everyone was like, why'd they pick Troll? Don't ask Stan King or question him. They ended up almost, they took that game 40 minutes. This was when OG was in their prime, and FDL actually showed extremely good games versus them. And we've seen it now with qualifying for their first LAN. Going for their second here, I'd really love to see him here.
Dire team back.
Dire team going for their last ban here. Silencer banned out, of course. Like I said, that core 30 pool that Stan King always does. We've seen him play Silencer so much, even in that series against NP last time they played. And Invoker banned out. So they're thinking Snake King's Heroes last middle, and no, not going to be the Morphling, which was probably the smart assumption. What do they want here? They want a support that can possibly deal with Omni Knight. Shadow Demon already out of the pool? I mean, there's not many. They could possibly go with an offlaner and play a super greedy four-position axe. They could do like a Beastmaster here. Reserve time. You know, Beastmaster is not a bad pick. I don't think they will, but if they did want to play the super greedy axe, a Beastmaster would be sick. We're gonna use all our reserve time here. Why not? You have it for a reason. It's not like you're in a bank vault and reserving your money. I literally don't know what that means. And it's the Pudge. Like we said, the run at you hero for 0-4, the Ogre, the Pudge, and there it is. If you haven't been watching NA Pubs, I've been casting a few, you will see so many Pudges lately. Ever since he got his level 1 hook buffed, he's just an insane hero. He doesn't get punished early game. He punishes the other team super hard, and I love this pick. It used to be a troll pick, but now it's a real pick. And I love this. This is interesting. The only thing, Pudge doesn't synergize well with, like, the Terrorblade pushing. I mean, obviously, Pudge, you get a pick off, then you can push with Terrorblade, but doesn't really bring anything else to the table besides a pick off or a save. And Storm Spirit. So here we go. Is this a Jubi Omni Knight, or is it going to be the Jubi Shadow Demon? Grant, his name's Jubi. He told me I could call him whatever I wanted. And I've been calling him Jubi for about 8 years now, so we're going to stick with that. And it is the Snake King Storm Spirit, along with Cole Ziz. That used to be what his name was when he went to TI5, but now he is Doo-Wop Ziz. And he is officially on the team after Mason left. That he still has the stand and text. You have to be on a team for a certain amount of time before you get the tag. This is going to be interesting. I think Jason will play the Shadow Demon, is my assumption, but they have 2 5 players. Jubi and Jason are both 5 players. I mean, 4 is not as different, but yeah. And now we wait as they do this thing. Know who does this every time? DC loves doing it. Misery literally does not pick us here till like 5 seconds after the game even starts. He'll waste even more time, my man. But we see, we sit, we wait. I'm excited for this. I haven't seen 0-4 play Pudge. I saw a lot of Ogre, not Pudge, but we will see the 0-4 Pudge. Probably roaming around middle. Storm super punishable by Pudge early until he gets 6. From levels 1 to 5, Pudge just dominates the Storm Spirit. Stan King versus Snake King, though. Her name just Stan. He's still Stanley King in my heart. The one true king, and here we go. Maybe. Uh-oh. My game just blew up. Uh-oh, guys. Okay, give me a sec here. Oh. We might be back. What in goodness gracious, his name's going on here. Reconnect, please. A great loading screen, by the way. This is probably my top 2 loading screens. This one, along with the Star Series Season 7, where the Lich is raising his hands. Alright, we're back. What's up, fam? I think a lot of people disconnected. Yeah, looks like a lot of people disconnected. That'll happen. Battle Cup Champion, Stan 747, Biza 04. Who are we missing? MJW? You there? Nope. Looks like a lot. Oop, Francis Lee, formerly known as Meninsky Fan Friend. Yeah, looks like everyone disconnected. Must be a bug. And here we go. We're going to have instant TPs coming out. Gonna be Jason going to ward up the middle lane. We're gonna have Blue, Snake King going middle. Gonna get pool tangles, I assume, by someone. Look at this cute little, I love this dog, Butch. And going down the list here, Doo-Wop going to be Snake King on the middle, Storm Spirit Juby on that support Shadow Demon, Ziz on the carry Morphling, we're going to have Francis Lee, a.k.a. Flea, playing on the Slardar, and then Omni Knight, played by Jason. Haven't seen many Omni Knights, but it's coming back around on the other side. Captain Stan King going to be playing that Dazzle. 747, a.k.a. Susie God, going to be playing OD. We're going to have Beza playing the Terrorblade. 0-4, that's a sick set. Going to be playing on that support Pudge with Boots. And then MJW on that Jungle Axe with the Iron Town. Doesn't look like we'll be having a fight. And look at already warded up here by Jason Smart. That's where he went to Smoke Ward. Light Blue's pinging out here, but they do not have the ward here, so... Interesting. Yellow maybe wants to cut creeps? This should be a little bit interesting. We wait. Looks like both teams will secure rune. Dire will get the top rune. Radiant will get the bottom rune. Shadow Demon will be himself. His head attached to nothing, if you guys were wondering. I always did. This is actually how I assume Snake King dresses in real life. My man right here. But, middle lane. This should be interesting. I think 747, one of the best, like... mechanical mid players you will see. The problem is his late game decision making's rather, like, if you had one of those diamonds where you talk about, like, pushing, skill cap, whatever that is, 747 definitely one of the best laners in the game right now. And then you get followed by his late game decision making, which has improved under Stan King. And here we go, 747 gonna put him under middle lane. The first couple CS are huge. How I always talk about, oh, whoa, Grant, okay, I don't know what happened. That's on me, everyone. That is definitely on me. First blood gets missed. It looked like he was trying to pull the creeps. I was so focused. But he pulled him into three heroes because the Axe was jungling. And, well, Pudge gets the first blood. And they get a free creep pull now. Which means, did Beza get good last hits? Yep, he got three out of the four under tower without a Quelling Blade. Is pretty dang good. Middle lane now. 747. Oh, misses that last hit. It's 4-1 right now against 1-0. Snake King dominating him. And he's going to just pull the creeps over here. Doesn't have any more tangos for 40 cents so he can eat him. Ziz, 6-1, complete free farm. Beza, my man. As long as he doesn't miss any more, he'll be fine. Missed that deny. Flea actually got full experience for it. And here we go. He's just going to metamorphose this up and harass him out of the lane. Pings out Pink. He says, come help me. Omni Knight actually jungling with no items. It's a new one. And here we go. The 0-4 level 2 already. That was huge top. We see Flea... getting shadow poisoned up. Flea just gets a little too weak. He gets done if he wants. He uses it. He'll get harassed one or two more times. That's about it. Top lane, though. Beza now. Easy to farm under tower with Metamorphosis. He's going to miss one of these, though. Yep, that was ungettable. It didn't matter. As long as it doesn't get denied, which one you go for, doesn't matter. A pull coming from Stan King. He should have let the creep actually hit him there. There we go. Middle lane. 0-4 sitting here. They don't have a ward middle, surprisingly. What? Oh, he could go for some crazy hook here. He doesn't. He does get harassed, though. Jason's here. Could heal him. No, just gives him a health potion instead. Actually, that was his own Grant. Wake up. You will do. Flea, get a run over. Stuns. Picks off one creep. He's going to get poison now, and that's going to be a decent amount of damage, especially with Sprint up. Taking 15% more damage. Misses the last hit. Middle lane now. Here we go. Pudge is coming back in. This is interesting. A Pudge OD versus Omni Storm. One of the... 0-4, missing a hook, but he's coming in with the rot now. The heal bomb's gonna come out. No, it's a repel, actually. They're just swinging them. Does he have his boots? He does not, but he might go down. Nice heal. And has his bottle, and he eats a tree, so he'll get a double heal from that tango. Ziz doing great. 19-6 bottom, doing exactly what he can. Flea, harassed down again. The fact that he already has level 3 is so huge for him. He can go to the jungle if he gets an Iron Tail now, which he can very quickly do. Meanwhile, OD does have boots now. If he would have had them before, he would have been perfectly fine. Snake King. Just sitting here middle. Doing a very good job. 14-5 versus 14-2. So after he gets a few levels, gets 2 points on Astral Imprisonment, a little bit easier. Now we see Flea and Beza just squaring up on each other. Poor man shield versus regular stout shield. And Beza, very good CSer himself. I think that's the biggest thing. NA player... how? Why? And now we see Jason. Well, they come through and another kill. 747 has 12 stick charges. And that was definitely... You don't expect a Pudge and Omni Knight to run each other middle, but they do. I'll take the blame on that one as well. I gotta focus. I'm not focused, and that's why. Just drank my energy drink. I can't say which one. Middle lane again? Nope. He was gonna. Looks like. Why didn't he bottle him? Oh, he placed his ball on the ground because Jason already had it. Okay. Now has infused raindrops, which is extremely good versus Astral Imprisonment spam. And ooh, 747 misses that CS because he thought Snakey was going for the deny. And he flies himself out of health potion. Should probably drop his bracer here. Yep, he does. Get the maximum amount of value. And he is good to go. Bottom lane. We've seen Juby has farmed uncontested in the jungle as well. He's almost level 5. Ziz is level 5.5, and Axe is only about 4. He is 5 now. Alright, good for him. So, it's scary. A free-farming Morphling is one of the scariest things. Pretty much, it seems like FDL is a little bit of a timing window with Beza. They want to get a kill, maybe a rotation kill on top, and then take the tower and just keep moving around the map every time Metamorphs is up every 2 minutes. And nice last hit, 747. Gonna put him under, take some of his raindrops away. Oh! Oh, and he moves forward. Smart play, but uh-oh! The poison comes out. He is not level 6. Jason's gonna heal him up and then repel him. They just have to square on him. 0-4 should probably not be repelling right. Rotting. He's gonna take a lot of damage. Now they're gonna put one under. 747 in a lot of trouble himself. He has Astral Imprisonment to get away if he really needs. Shadow Poison comes up. 2 stacks on 747. That's gonna be it. So no kill going either way. Perfect Omni Knight play as well as a TPing and Shadow Demon. And now Axe. Battle Hunger, no creeps here. He needs to either get a deny, but no, he won't. Battle Hunger will tick down on him. It's only level 1, mostly just for the move speed, and to aggro creeps off towers. Top lane, Beza versus Flea. Middle lane, still fighting. Brings himself another health potion, and a huge deny on the range creep. Obviously 90 equals 45 experience for half. Very big, 747 missing a few last hits. Maybe he should just orb him. Doesn't want to waste mana, though. I mean, you see Ziz is just dominating it, 50 up on the enemy team's carry, but the other two, I mean, the middle is 50 up on the other, so it's reasonably even right now. Should get all these last hits. Yep, good last hitting there from 747, including the deny. Top lane, they're actually going for Fleet, takes a lot of damage, but level 1 poison, not that big of a slow. And now, 747 just get a farm up. I think they're fine with this, but Snake King is doing jungle stacks, and that's huge. Gets him to level 6 himself, get a bottle up, has his soul ring when he gets the recipe. It's pretty much up to Ziz right now. Ziz has to perfectly free farm, and then he might need to actually start showing up to fights if they keep losing these engagements. Let me see Snake King. He's trying here to do these jungle camps. He might have to come get healed by Jason, who doesn't have mana, so that's not gonna happen. And look at, we see Yellow's pinging out that they want to kind of do the rotation we were talking about, but Metamorphs is about to go down, so I don't think they will. Stand King. Place the sentry, see if there's a ward middle. I believe he just missed out on it. Yep, sure did. That's a rough one. The piranha plant will live. Peach schnapps and fly. And now 747 doing stacks, or is he going to leave him for Axe to get his blink? Nope, he's going to do him. He's like, sorry, MJW. I still remember one of the first MJW games I really loved watching. He played a off-lane Iron Talon Lina, ended up going 20-0. I think it was versus a decent team at the time. I think it was versus Shazam. What a game that was. MJW's quite the player. Looks like we are going to have Ring of Aquila coming out for Beza. So next time Metamorphs up in 50 seconds, they're definitely going to want to take a tower. Flea? You going to throw up that amp damage? He still has 5 armor. My man still has 5 armor. 6 when he's under tower. Look, he's just going to fight him. Uh-oh. MJW come from behind. He is going to use that. Does he have a tree eater? He does, but he tries to juke, and he does juke down. The call comes up. Sunder comes out. This should be a 3-man stomp. Doesn't quite get off because the call is there, and that's a huge kill for them. Killing that Slardo, who is level 6. Everyone's at a reasonably high level right now. What do we got here? What is hero level? E. I mean, look at this. Lowest levels are 4, which isn't bad at 8 minutes. Sometimes you see people level 4 at 20 minutes in, so could be a lot worse, but Ziz, still just farming. He's going to have a very early Lincolns. Jason going to bring out his magic wand. 0-4. Maybe they want him to get 6 on the Pudge, so before the Lincolns, they get a free kill with his Dismember. And Beza just completely out of position there. And that is why, you know, sometimes you have a cameraman. Wish I did. I'm too stuck on the little thing. 0-4 now. He goes for the hook. He actually hits Francis Lee. Gets the instant stomp, and he actually walks through him. Thank goodness Sprint gives you that ability now. Is that a level 2 poison? Nope, still level 1, and Juby gonna put him under on the Shadow Demon. And just keep him away. Sick hook there, but not quite enough. Here comes MJW. He's just gonna run in, though. He thought about it. He's gonna be level 8, so he's doing great. Dire Structures fortified bottom. We're gonna see... Oh, it canceled TB. So just MJW TBing in. I believe Gray actually canceled his. Yep, sure did. All he has to do is just farm. He's doing his job. His team's playing great. They're only down one kill, which doesn't mean anything. Look at gold. They're up about 500. Experience, about 520 as well. So Jason being level 6 doesn't skill the ult. Extremely mana inefficient. I mean, look at that. 125 when he has a base mana pool of 410. You'd rather get two heals and two repels off than an ultimate. OD. Just farming up. Has drums. Going the kind of the old build we used to see. Gives him a little more mobility. Allows him to fight earlier, which they want to do with Terrorblade, especially against Morphling. Francis. Farming top. They haven't really... The whole reason you pick, like, a Pudge-Axe kind of duo to roam around in the mid-game... Oh! Goes for the hook, just gets the cream. He's fine. Alright, I'll get a CS. And a Smoke Gang actually coming from Shadow Demon as well as Omni Knight. But no one's down here. So a gank it will be not. Treads up on 747. They might just take this tower. They know Glyph's down. No one's gonna you're not gonna TP into these three heroes, so they're just gonna rope. They're gonna get the first tower, very surprisingly, versus the bees at Terrorblade. They're pinging it. I mean, it's gone. There's no way. He can just repel them and run if they really need. And yep. Let's hope Ziz gets it. Oh, the inefficiency. Top lane. Hook is up. Do they want to go for anything? Nope. Beeza does have Metamorphosis now. About 1,000 off Dragonlance and nothing really happening. 747 farming decently, but Morphling's 1,000 ahead already. Storm caught up by doing those stacks against the OD, and Beeza's a tad bit behind right now. Ping's bottom. They know someone's there. He just wanted to make an illusion of him. Middle, the smoke gank with Pudge. He is level 6. Oh... dear. That was a weird little misplay from FDL. I don't know why Pudge ran up. He ran up when MJW had his blink on the axe, so axe, like, the Pudge came out of the smoke, and it just gave away the entire gank, so a little misplay there by FDL. MJW's like, well, I'm going back to farming. I don't know what the heck that was. Stand King, level 5. Ziz still farming. I believe he is has his ulti orb, right? Yep, sure does. He's gonna have about 13-minute Lincolns, as well as a magic wand. Shades of his TI5 time with complexity. A very good carry. Carried him decent placing at TI5. People seem to forget that. They played a very nice one kind of style, and they played it well. Ziz was perfect for that, kind of a TC style. But here we go. Finally, the Metamorphosis push top lane. MJW gets the call on nobody, and Storm comes in now, flying in. MJW taking a lot of damage. She's Demonic Purge, too. But the Sunder comes out from Beeza on the backside. Jason just dies. Shadow Demon goes down as well. I don't know what Susie's doing. Almost kills Snake King, too. But it's a 2-for-1 trade. They do lose their OD, who they don't want to lose. My man was in the back lines. And a clutch Sunder coming out of Beeza, though, to save MJW and get him another kill. So two supports for an OD, not Terrell for Duob. They don't even lose the tower. Dropping the old Tranquil Boot drop. Easy farmings. Snake King farming extremely well now. Soul Ring, he is only about... Oh, and he's going on Stand King. Can he bring him down? Does he have pull? He does not have one in pull. You can't do that. I don't even think you'd get him with one in pull. Do a little more damage, but obviously can heal, Grave, they teleport in. If you use all your mana, you're just doomed. I don't know. Well, I do know. It seems like FDL's falling a little bit farther behind every time they take a fight. You're saying, Grant, they're winning by 2 kills. It doesn't mean much when your Terrorblade's just now picking up his about 14-minute Dragonlance once he flies the courier out. He might just run back and heal. And now... top looks like it's going to get pushed in. If Flea can get a Blink Dagger after this fight, they would be so far ahead. top lane, and look at this, 0-4 sitting behind. Lincoln's up on our man. They just have to get out of here. Yep, and Pudge already TV's back. MJW has a blink. He is not as scared. Creeps get cleared out, and it's looking like another free tower. Obviously, the Shadow Demon trick. Make illusions, and then Morphling can make an illusion of himself, even though you're not supposed to be allowed to. I'm really surprised they haven't fixed that sort of thing. They're still pushing in top, too. So that's two tier ones down for Doo-Wop. They're looking good, and they're just pushing forward. He has Blink very soon. He wants to get all these creeps. Let's see if he does. Gets it. Oh, but he gets called in. This is not good. Jason needs to get in there, heal him, and then repel him. There it is, the heal repel. MJW is it's Pier. They're just going to put him under. Now the axe could spin on them. Better watch out. Don't attack him. Over here. Takes off the... oh, he's just dead. Interesting play. Slaughter does go down to the Pudge in the backside, though. Ziz gets the Pudge. And another one-for-one trade. OD TP's in a little bit late. Uh-oh. And look who it is. Regen'd up. Snake King. That's going to be it. So another... I mean, not a loss for Doo-Wop, even though they do lose the Blink Dagger on Slaughter. He was about 50 gold off. And already they have to use the glyph super early on this tier 1 tower, and now, I mean, Radiant's going to be fine just pushing it. Terrorblade, OD, both not that far. They're good at getting a pickoff and then pushing. Doo-Wop's team is good at just pushing. They don't need to get that pickoff. But OD now does have the 4 staff, so a lot of more mobility himself as well as damage. He's level 11. But we see Snake King. He has the Bloodstone if he wants to purchase it. No, he's 70 gold off, my bad. Why is his head so small? Anyone notice that? That's like, actually, I said he kind of looks like Snake, and that's the opposite. Snake has a really big head in real life. Not ego, just a big head. I miss that grin of his. Hope he makes it to another land. Actually, I hate that grin of his. Never mind. Ziz just gets out of there, and nice play. Makes him rotate his 5 bottom, and then he just goes middle and farms. Already has the Ghost Scepter. Only about 2,500 off of that Ev Blade. And he could have by about 20-minute mark if he farms well. And look at, they know they can push this tower bottom lane. Rune gets stolen by Snake King. Gets the invisibility rune. He's out of there. My goodness, he actually pops it. I'm actually surprised he popped it instead of just going straight home and healing, getting his Bloodstone, then ganking. Wow, Bloodstone, Null, Bottle, we see the mid tower get denied. Snake King sitting here has one in pull now. Ooh, and 747's all by himself. Does Slaughter have his blink? He does, and he's going middle. This could, oh. Does he see himself getting blocked? There it is, the level one pull. He's going to have to do something. Oh, Frenzly doesn't blink far enough. He still has his 4-step. The hook comes. Now the 4-step's back up. MJW missed the column. They get the dismember, though. Snake King's out of mana. He's going to lose almost all of it. The Bloodstone's gone. Francis Lee losing a lot of dead. Stand King, what's my man doing? He comes from behind. And here comes 747. One more hit. He's dead. Can they get it? He puts him under. That's going to kill him on the backside. Jason healing up Ziz. They do have an illusion. And MJW, they should be able to possibly get Jason. Very fitting as Halloween comes. Once a year. A call actually on Snake King again. Oh my goodness. I mean, they're not going to kill him. He loses a lot of his life there. Can't even bottle up through that the battle hunger right now. And they're just going to take this tower. No, the glyph. Will we see it? Yeah, he's going to repel. He's going to go for the swag. Can he get it? No, they're just going to go on at 747. The 4-step out. Ziz denies it, though. They have to be very careful. We see this member coming out. Juby, can they pull him out of it? They do. He puts him under. He's going to live for a little bit longer. This is not going to be good for him, though. He gets Demonic Purge on 747. They get the kill on Juby. Jason now going to try to run away. MJW blinks forward. Call. Guess what? It goes through Appel, my man. So does Dunk. He doesn't even need it. Gets a spin on the last second. And FDL, they got it. The pickoff and the tower push. Oh, no. And who's this? Whoever it is dead. It's Snake King. No! But a good play by Flea, stunning all of them up. He has a little bit of time to get away. He does. The hook comes and it hits his own teammate. But 747 goes forward. So aggressive. MJW with the dunk. And that's a 3-0. That's like a 5-0 with how many times they respond. They're going for the tower. And this is what we said. One pickoff in the tower. Another pickoff, 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 pickoff. My goodness. And that is about as perfect as it gets. Terrorblade now has Yasha and 800. S, Grant, you were going to say S4, that's 0-4. At this point, 0-4 is a little bit better. Also, if you do go by numerical value, a 0 is technically ahead of an S, making 0-4 a better player than S4. That's just numericals. I'm not actually calling if it's better or not. But yeah, exactly. I know you guys are saying, Grant, you have a lot of knowledge to bestow upon us, and that's why I do. Flea farming up. He has his blink at 18 minutes. Not terrible. He had about 60 minutes, but his levels, 9. Let's see MJW. 11 and a half. Of course, 11. 2,200 experience. The longest of levels to be halfway through that. That's almost 2. That's level 1 through 4 right there alone. It's a lot. Grant, you're making that up. I probably am. Stanky moving around. He's almost level 9. My goodness. He's, after that initial, look at that. 0 death. 007 the dream. The anti-Malk. You're useful and you have a lot of assists. Radiant uses scan up here. No one's here, so a wasted smoke gank, it looks like. Grant lagging a little. Who are we going to blame that on? Maybe the Xbox DVR thing. I think I disabled that, though, so we'll not blame it on that. And now the blade mill on Axe. That's huge. Ziz still, and he's a little bit off that Ed Blade now, about 1,200. He needed that by about the 20-minute mark. Now that he doesn't have it, it's gonna be rough. They can just 5-man. What can you do against FDL's 5-man? Pudge will occasionally get a pickoff. He has Blink now. 747's ultimate actually does quite a bit of damage now. He's got the ult orb. 1,500 life with Intruds on. That's a lot of HP and damage he's pumping out. And Blue, snaking my man with the 5 Bloodstone. He flies up top. B's actually... What? B's just kills with illusions. I wanted to see if they got Snake King, but Snake King using that brain of his barely gets out. Now they're going to try to push top. I think it's a smart play. That's what they have to do on Morphling when you're losing a game. Split push, split push, split push. Of course, Repel. Not that good versus an Axe. Call goes through Repel. Spin goes through Repel. So if you want to know the pick order, it came out... I don't even remember. First pick was OD, and then it was Omni Shadow Demon. Axe was the second pick for FDL, and that's such a good pick for Omni. That was just really smart. So they didn't get Omni OD, which they wanted. Instead, they get Axe, who is extremely good for Omni. Just good picking. Stand King, great drafting. Manta style almost on terribly. Does he have the recipe already? He does. So he has his Manta. That is a 21 minute. But look at. He's just sitting there, creeping and crawling like Mike Jones. Juby having a somewhat, not off game, he's 0-2-1, only involved in one kill, they only have 4. He's played very well defensively with the good disruptions, but as good as defensive Shadow Demon is, you kind of want to play offensive, like disruption into Blink Stun by Slardar, but bottom lane getting pushed in now by 747. Apologies if I call him Susie. It's a bad habit, and you need to break habits, trust me. My grandma smoked for 45 years. She never broke her habit. You guys thought it was a good ending. It wasn't. 04 was looking for a hook, but nothing there. And Beez is just farming. He's just going to farm with illusions. His illusions are pretty farmed. And now we're at a little bit of an impasse. Or stalemate. No, I think impasse is right. Is it? It could be. Oh, gets it. Nice, Beza, my man. Flea is just sitting. He's been sitting here for about the last 2 minutes. We can follow him on his journey through the world. He's here. He blinks in. This illusion's going to get hammered on. He goes for the creep first. Gets it. Gets it. You're next, bub. Oh, he's going to let him farm up. It's a little bit suspect of a play. He's actually going to get... He gets it. He lets him get 2 CS. That's interesting. It's a... One of those weird, super little, like, min-max kind of misplays from Flea. Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. Beez are now just farming middle. Dire's top tower. MJW's here with them. 1.2k on him. Beeza, 1.6k on him. They have Aegis on the OD. It's just so hard. He almost has a sheep if he wants. He might go to Lincoln's. I've seen both on 747. And look at top lane getting hammered right now, though. It just unhealable damage. They might take this tower down. They do. They blit the bling on Zizzy. Oh, he has it though. But he gets spun on. My goodness. And now Flea's getting eaten up. This is not good. Heal bomb him. Doesn't need to. The dunk gets blocked by Lincoln's. But somehow MJW with one creep on him spins and kills him. And the tower gets denied by a B's illusion. But that's a tier 3 tower down. That's not the worst. And now it means there's an open racks for when the Morphling gets his Manta. It's super easy pickings. So they lose Morph and... Slardar, but they gain a tier 3. At this point, that's kind of a wash. for Doo-Wop. I keep wanting to call him DW. Then you guys are going to think I'm talking about Arthur. I hate DW. God, I hated DW. You know, she wanted Arthur, but Arthur was not about that life. Looks like you're going for the Tier 1 tower top. Should be free. Yep, pretty dang free. Oh. Huh. My man is going for the evasion. The one that makes them where they can't attack Gretchen? You know what the name of that is? Probably. I'll figure it out. It's Heaven's Hallbred, you idiots. I knew that. Hethblade comes out, and look at this. The siege begins. And that tower drops pretty quick. Quicker than Twitter stock if the NFL on Twitter doesn't work, that's for sure. Morphling Illusion goes down, of course. The Arcane Orb mollywops it. 747 just gonna farm up middle. He has the Aegis, he's fine. 2.8k as well. We do see the Orchids on Snake King. But, I mean, 5 charge Bloodstone plus Orchids, 24 minutes in, it's rough. Jason, Aetherlens. We haven't seen much of him. We haven't seen one Guardian Angel yet. Sheepstick now, as well as Vanguard. Looks like he probably will be going for the upgraded Vanguard. We'll call it the upgraded Vanguard. I'm actually really surprised he didn't go Assault Kyrus. They don't really have an Assault Kyrus holder. No, he's going Sanjin Yasha? You don't get the increased move speed. I've tried it. He just wants stats. Why not go for a second dragon? You know, I'm actually kind of confused. I might ask him after the game. Because it is extremely good stats, don't get me wrong, but so is Dragonlance. We hear a fresh meat coming. He's just eating creeps. Going for that 8th one. That's just kind of a weird pickup. Because you don't get the extra move speed from Manta plus Sanjin Yasha, so he stays the same. Damn. It's a gorgeous courier, Blitzball champion. Now they're just pushing in top. Look at this ward. They can see this up here as well. Not much. I mean, they want to try to split push top and get that, but Dire's going to be very quick to not let that happen. Snake King trying to run away. He's zipping and zooping. My man trying to ball Battle Hunger, putting in work. But he will survive. Four Arcane Rune. Don't want to give that one to Storm, I'll tell you that much. I don't think we have to worry about that, though. Oh my goodness. He should have waited until... It's actually a really weird, like, function. If something's on cooldown, you pick up an Arcane, it's fine. It's like a 0.5 second loss. If they want, they can just push in with these images. With the 11 second cooldown, my goodness. Dan King, 04. Aetherlens, what's our hook looking like? It's pretty far. Francis Lee, though. My man loves the jungle up here. He's been chilling up here, over here. He's level 11 at 27 minutes in. What's hero level? There it is, E. This is actually a big tell of the game. Your offlane's 11, the other's 13. They're doing decent, but Biza, playing the level 16, doing fine. I really would have liked to seen a Shiva's or an Assault Kyrus. I'm surprised we didn't on MJW. Game slowed down a tad bit. Looks like we're going to have BKB next on Outworld Devour. No, actually, it's probably Dragonlance, Grant. Yep, sure is. Good thing I caught myself before I said something stupid. MJW is getting pinged out. Are they going to go for anything here? Oh, we're about to find out. Ziz is here, Ethblade and all. Got him. There it is, very close to the Hurricane Pike. Shout out to Gregory Helms. Boots of Travel now up on Ziz, so Boots of Travel probably into Manta next so we can do some split pushing. Get a throw him under, get some extra farm. 747's chilling here. He's like, nah, these illusions one shot him. And that's gonna be the end of that. That was a tough fight. Oh, come on. You're really gonna miss a CS on OD at level 16 this late in the game? Bruh. Uh-oh, Snake King? The Blinken! He comes! Oh no, and he gets the illusion for Snake King! Can they bring him down? No, 747 just sitting up here. He's waiting. Okay. That's interesting. What's our intelligence? 69 plus 33, that's 70. That is 103 versus 135? He definitely could have killed him with one arcane orb into ult. I'm actually... He had a sheep! What? Oh, 747. A missed kill, actually. Like, a legitimate missed kill there with 747. Whoa! Yo, he almost... He had a timing there. He could have almost got put under. That was very scary. Grant stuttering a little bit, getting so hype. Top lane pushed in by Ziz. This is what they have to do. Split the map and hope they don't get picked off, and they're doing a good job of it right now. Beeza will just farm with illusions while Ziz pushes out. Unfortunately, once these creep die, they are not going to have any backups. What are he's going for next? It could be an Assault Curious. You don't want to get it on your Terror Blade, but it, I mean, it's not terrible. The only reason you get Sanj and Yasha at this point in the game is because you want to just push into their base with the extra stats. I'm drinking water out of a wine glass right now. Laundry day's tomorrow. Yule's up on the Slardard. Decent save for himself. Stormsphere Boots of Travel now. I'm usually a big person against Boots of Travel in a losing game. But when you have a Morphling, he's one of the few heroes that I think it's fine on. There's a Diffusal Blade on him now, so that's a lot of damage. If they get... Oh. Please help. No Force Staff on any of them. Well, oh. Alright, they're both just gonna chill. They're just fiends. Come on, bro. What? Wait, did they just... Were they on top of a ward? That's a Radiant Ward, right? Alright. They literally just sat on the Radiant Ward, hooked him up, he fell in. They know they're in there, right? He literally just fell from a cliff. Looking like 72 hours stuck between a rock and a hard place, but 0-4. Who's gonna get the last hit? Susie does. In top lane, no damage on that ranged barracks yet. I mean, we're just pushing. We're at about 5, not that much, 5,200 net worth as well as about 5,000 experience. Ziz is just moving around the map. He's moving around the map gracefully. I'm making a go on. 747 just dies. Pudge dies as well. That was just an interesting play. And oh, he gets the Sunrod very long range. He is getting massacred by his own illusions. Get a Fusel Blade off. He's going to try to TP. They don't have enough damage. Get healed up. What is he doing? Beeza. Beeza. Oh my goodness. Ziz. No, I'm just going to farm up. Doo-Wop's playing this game. With the disadvantage they're at, they're playing it perfectly right now. And they're getting another free tower. Only one tier 2 stands if they bring this one down, but looks like he'll back up. He might go for it. Yeah, I think he will. No? He's not. He'll let the siege damage put in the work. Smart play. No reason to force it. It will probably be deniable. Yeah, it will be. Get one more hit on the tower. Oh, it might finish it off. They have two creeps that can tank for him. Beeza, don't mess this up. He doesn't. Denies it. Shadow Demon picking up some Tomes of Knowledge. Two of them, to be precise. That's 850 experience. Good man. Classic math. Snake King just moving around. Looks like he's going for Lincolns next. Not bad. Repel plus Lincolns. Flea's coming in. 747 gets silenced in. This is going to be a huge kill if they get him. He has Sheep and Hurricane Pike. He just dies. And another kill. I don't know. That's Dire's Ward. He's just getting picked off. That's two deaths in the last 2 minutes for him. And Doo-Wop just playing very calm, very patient. That's why Snake King went to TI. Ziz. Moving in slowly here. Lee now getting decent form. He has 2K. I don't know what he really wants to go. I think 4 staff's still good. It's even 30 minutes in. Just gonna clear out these neutrals. Snake can get a move around the map. JW looks like they realize, wait a minute, we went Sanjin Yasha, 4th item Terrorblade, we should probably be pushing. Oop, that's going to be nice. Those will clear out the illusions very quickly. And here we go, looks like they're just going to push in, but look at this counter push coming from Ziz and Flea. He has 20 seconds to do some damage, might get about 5 seconds worth, but oh my, and the glyphs already used, and look at Beza. My man, bruh, he's just running at him. And they're just going to be able to take down this tower. They have no glyph. My goodness, that's a lot of damage. He still has Manta. He wants to save it in case the Storm Spirit goes on him. It's a smart play. He's going to get handled by his own illusions right now. They're flying in. Snake King gets cheaped up. His Lincolns comes down. Snake King can't heal anyone. Can't do anything right now. Just getting pulled in. 747 lose a lot of damage. We see a Sunder come out. Hook! Ooh, hey, Mr. Cart. Illusions fighting each other. Flea, is Flea going to go in? He sure is. Doesn't hit anyone. Oh, and he eats Lee. My man just went in! And they're gonna fly now. Snake King still doesn't have that much mana. Top Barracks dies to Ziz. He's split pushing everything. They're not doing anything. And Snake King's about to go down. And 0-4 is gonna go down. This is gonna be a 2-for-0 as well as a range Drax. A 3-for-0. What? When did Axe die? Oh. Duop just won a 4v5 team fight while Morphling split push. Has a Manta. And that's what we're talking about now. This is what PPD always says. Morphling is the best late game hero. He does everything. He's good in fights, and he can split push. Split push harder than anyone, especially with a Shadow Demon on your team. You can make illusions of yourself, and they're going to counter push down middle. Sup, cat? Look at Snake King. Usually Storm Spirit. Not that big of a tower pusher. He's doing decent, though. Oh, miss the last hit. Lose a little bit of gold there. Hurricane Pike now on the Terrorblade, and it feels like they're kind of falling off here. Still 2.6k. Yeah, I don't know what he gets. I would still like Assault Curious, but I think he might need a Butterfly here. But once my man here gets his Bloodthorn, it's going to be curtains for almost all of FDL. No BKBs purchased. 747 getting harassed. Ziz actually getting sheep. He's going to take a lot of damage. Will he be able to bring it? Nope. Welcome to Repel Village. Jason hits him with it. And he's out of here. What is the range on Repel with Aether Lens? That's pretty damn big. Heal even bigger. Lincolns plus Repel now on 2 heroes. Storm, as well as the Morphling. Top lane, we're actually getting MJW. He doesn't, the creep's in his way. And now he's gonna get handled. Flea has to use BKB, got that instead of force. I can respect that. Yule's up in the air on 747. This could be a lot of damage. He actually could blink. Oh, he gets hit once, and he is gonna be going down now. Dazzle gets the kill. Going for a pipe. A 1-for-1, not bad again. Offlane for offlane. 16 for level 16. Slardar is actually caught up somehow after that big. I mean, when you win a 4v5 team fight, you're gonna gain a lot of levels. I don't know what Dire needs to do. It feels like they kind of missed their window. I mean, they're still fine. They took down this, took down most of the range Drax. They still have Metamorphosis push if they want. But Juby's just going in on him. Puts him under, then Demonic purges him, makes him not able to farm. Jason flying around, Morphling. We don't even know anymore. It is a BKB. Now we do know. He's going to have Lincolns, Repel, and BKB all at his need. You mean on his hand? Sure. Storm flies in. Grant's camera flies out. Bottom lane! Uh-oh, Blue's coming in! I think you go on Stan King, not 747 here. No, they do go on 747. No, goes on both, throws down the armor, needs to get some heals up. Axe comes in with the call in the back, doesn't get the battle longer. Sheep's up now. Can Snake King go down? That would be such a big kill. He beat... He didn't beat him. He got repelled, but he goes down. Guardian Angel down as well. And look at who they find. Jason on the backside. Another kill. Axe gets it. And a huge turnaround. All the Bloodstone charges he earned back. He's now under the median. Or the mean. Or is it mode? I failed algebra. And Ziz got out of there, and he's just going to split push. That's the Morphling life, my man. Morph just spinning about. Ziz. He's played perfectly so far. They're going to take down... How's Purple's TP? He doesn't have it, but he does have an image he can send back to base, which is fine. They're going for the melee, but there's no creeps in the base yet. Oh, now, there we go. They're close enough, but 747's already TP'd back. He's looking for stragglers. Snake King won't find any, and a tier 2 for a tier 2? But look at this. My goodness, this tier 3, so much unhealable damage gone. Scotty up now on the Terrorblade. What? I'm lagging a little? Okay, wait up. Let's... I think I should be good. I was just dropping frames, I believe. Should be good now. That's probably on my end. It might also be because my freaking... I need to open a window in here. It is very hot. We're going to follow around snaking now. Boy, my goodness, it is hot in here. Repel up on Storm Spirit, 4.6k, get to take a small drain, make that 4.6. Jason, I mean, Juby now has Boots of Travel. All they need now is Omni Knight to have them, and they will be in good position. They can just literally 5-man TP around the map if they really want it. Storm Spirit! Goes in, then goes out. 747 in a very wary position, but the rest of his team behind him as well. Stupendous. MJW looking for anyone he can find. Hook comes out, they find Jason! What a pickoff! No buyback, but middle already pushed in. Like we said, the Morphling game. It's the long con. Look at this, the siege on the tower begins. The siege on Mordor. Star Trek's always been one of my favorite movies. No, that's Lord of the Rings, my bad. Not The Hobbit. Uh-oh, and Snake King gets disabled. He ulties, he's gonna be able to fly away though. No, he doesn't, no he is. They need to find him. And then look at him, look at his brothers. His brother gave him away. And he has to suicide. Why? A mirror of his brother gives him away. Whoa, what the hell? MJ... God's name? Well, a wasted BKB on Axe, I guess. And they are going to get another Roshan. And there it goes. Cheese will go on MJW. Aegis on Outworld Devour. Still has a slot here and sell drums for a slot, so reasonably farmed. Reasonably under-farmed is what I meant, unless he has something right here already. He does not. Huh. Battle comes Stanley. Stanley, go. Flee. Moving around. Doing decently. Just get a farm. I mean, what are we looking at here? Radiant favored in experience. Net worth going back in favor of Dire, about 2,000, so... The problem is the split push. the Shadow Demon we have in Boots of Travel is insane right now. He literally can move around with the Morphling almost 24/7, and they can just siege down anything. Look at this. Almost no HP. Lost a little bit here as well. They have to be so cautious of that and flee once again the top jungle, his home. As he eats in. Tarzan, where are you, my friend? Grant, isn't he a Naga? Doesn't he live underwater? Tarzan, if people didn't know, actually used to live underwater. It was a bit surprising when I first learned it. Tarzan actually used to date Ariel from The Little Mermaid. And, of course, Queen Ursula didn't like that, and that is why you have the Beauty and the Beast. It's Disney stuff. You guys probably wouldn't understand. You're not... I mean, Universe would. And there it is. Look at the... Is this a joke? But you were getting so much free damage on this tower. Why would you go in and die? He only takes that tower down, too. 633, 859. Force a buyback on the Morphling is what they have to do. We're going to see Storm just move around. Look at Beza. He's just going to run at him. Sup, dog? Almost 6 slotted. Level 2 Diffusal, and then maybe sell the Sanjin Yasha for a Butterfly, but the split push from Slardar. Will this? Yep, that'll be the last of that wave. They're going to force the buyback right now. And he... Oh, they're just... Look at this. Do they have a Glyph up again? They sure do. That Rags drops. You're going to see possibly a buyback right at the end of the glyph. No, they're... Flea goes in, there's the buyback! A BKB on Flea, he gets dismembered though! They don't do enough damage without the Arcane Orb, now we're going to see a pull in by 747. He does have Aegis, oh, Waveform coming on the backside, they're trying to bring down Sand King before he can get Grave up. 747 puts himself under, we see Beza just chasing down Juby, that's not going to be enough though, 0-4 still away. Sand King graves himself, he's running, Snake King's looking for anyone, he can't find anybody! Beza killing himself from the illusion, Ziz gets blown up in the hook, saves MJW, they have a repelled Jason, that's not good, buyback from Slardar, he'll be full everything, it's now a 3-for-1 trade, and Jason's dead, no buyback, this Rax about to be dead, they're just chasing Snake King though, Juby, he's like, give me illusions, but they'll take this Rax easily, illusions, they're... Who's winning? The Radiant Illusion wins. No, it's still fighting. Now he's fighting this Illusion, chasing down Beza. They're going to go for this Rax, though. Ooh, gets the Soul Catcher on him. He is... Oh, my goodness! They just going... He's going to die! He doesn't have it! He has buyback if he really wants, so 747 needs to get this kill. That's no buyback complete! No! A perfect duel. Can they somehow bring him down? No! It comes out and gets him! They bring down 747, now puts him under. Snake King's going to go down as well. No buyback. We might be seeing GGs here, boys. Juby goes down. Good game, good game. Great game for all! What a last fight. Everyone was around. Stan King was an MVP that fight. He kept everyone alive, graved himself, keep everyone alive even more. And that was an FDL victory, game one. Now I have to do this overlay stuff. We're going to see how it goes. Probably very poorly, but let's look at the scoreboard first. We'll give you a rundown. The Grand Grant rundown. Brought to you by 100 TV. I'm just kidding. Snake King, 6-6-3. Not the worst game he had. But not the best game user net worth, 23,000. He was actually number one after Ziz bought back there. Number one net worth, even above 747. Grant B's at 29. He's 6,000 below him. That's very true as well, so he was actually second. But thanks to that, everyone, we will now be heading into game two here. And yeah, see you soon, I think. Well, let's see if I do this right.